Hello, welcome to my channel once again. China malls in Ghana have been closed down. Yes, China malls in Ghana have been closed down. And recently I went there to do window shopping, one of their malls, and I saw that most of the things that I need, they sell them there. So why not even buy it directly from that place? Yeah, so that's actually what I told myself. I will go there and just buy the stuff from there rather than going on the net and just searching for all these things. So just yesterday I was in a bus going somewhere and I passed in front of their one of their branches, yeah. And upon passing by, I saw that the China Mall has been closed, and it was a weekday. It wasn't even a Sunday. It was a weekday, not even weekend. So I was like, why? Then a conversation actually started in the bus, and people started talking about, you know, Ghanaians, you know, sometimes an issue comes and people start saying whatever they feel like saying, you know. And they were talking, and most of the people were like, why would the government close down a mall like that? That these people, like you people are not, you politicians are not creating jobs, and you've closed down someone's mall that they have come here to employ Ghanaians. And I think from what I heard, I actually went there to do like window shopping. So to my surprise, you know, sometimes some people say a lot of things about Chinese and all that, but I saw that most of the people working there were Ghanaians. Most of the workers there were Ghanaians. Most of the workers there were Ghanaians. I don't know, but I feel that is a good thing, because people coming from their countries to come and establish these type of stuffs in Ghana, and they deciding to employ Ghanaians. Charlie, I think it's a good move, you understand? That's my opinion though. But another thing that the people were saying were like, the government, why the government closed down these shops and all that. And I'm like, you don't know what has actually happened, so you people should just cool down, because these things that you, like, you people are saying, is like you are just saying these things out of your like how you feel, or like maybe the hardship that is in the country that people are actually talking about. So our people are experiencing, and all of us are experiencing it, you understand? But sometimes take time and just do what and listen to what actually happened, the reason behind they closing this. So what I actually did was I went onto the net and checked, and behold, I saw a news portal that was saying, you know, the Chinese like the China malls have been closed, about four branches have been closed, because these people, it seems there was a directive that was brought, that's the Ghana Revenue Authority brought out prior to its implementation. That's I think 1st October, yeah, I think 1st October, that's when the thing was to start. And we are, and today is like the 15th or the 16th of, I don't know when I'm going to post this, but I'm just saying today is like 15th or the 4th, yeah, the 16th of October. And it seems like these people are not really doing what, complying with the directive. So that's mainly the reason why the GRA came to close down the China malls, because they are not complying with the directives. I would read what I actually saw on the news portal to you, so that you can understand what they actually mean. Okay, so the source that I'm reading this from is the Ghana News Agency, and it reads, GRA closes China Mall shopping centers for non-compliance with tax laws. This was published on October 10th, 2022. So it says in Accra, October 10th, the GRA, the enforcement officials of the Ghana Revenue Authority, has closed four branches of the China Mall shopping facility in Accra, facilities in Accra,
for non-compliance of the e-invoicing system for value-added tax introduced by the authority. The authority rolled out the e-invoicing system for VAT collectors from October 1st, 2022 to 600 large taxpayers that generate more than 90% of VAT revenue. Unlike the manual system, the e-invoicing system allows the GRA to monitor live transactions in companies where it has been deployed, thereby making it impossible for taxpayers to either under invoice or avoid the payment of VAT. When the officials first visited the Spinters Road branch of the facility, the shopping center was not in operation, but GRA said the suspected management had information about the action. Others are the Ashaiman and the Amasaman branches. Mr. Joseph Annan, area enforcement manager of GRA in charge of Accra Central, told the Ghana News Agency that the authority had been engaging management of some selected businesses on how to commence the system, but most of them had failed to comply. He said when they got to the premises, the shops were not in operation, so we only added the Commissioner General's seal. He said even though it only sealed, any attempt to take it off was an offense against the law, and until the right things were done on their part, the place would remain closed.
It's mainly about, I think, e-invoicing, like electronic invoicing or something. I think an electronic invoicing or something that the GRA has brought, because I think they really want everybody to pay the right taxes, because if you don't know what you are selling and how the amount of things that you are selling, how can you pay the right VAT or the right tax to the government? You understand? So right tax to the government. So that's actually what I saw, and I'm like, this is not a bad idea, like a bad thing. This is not a bad thing, because I feel for them, they are just doing their job, because there is a directive that has been given, and you are not complying, so they are here to just let you know that, hey, you are not complying, so you should comply. You understand? And I think it's a good thing for me. And you know, most Africans, we have this perception, or even I think African Americans, they have this perception that the Chinese are in Africa and they are taking over Africa and all that. But I think this is something that you can easily an evidence that they are not taking over Africa or something, but the authorities in each African countries are perhaps taking charge and making sure they are actually doing the right thing. You understand? So this is one thing that's actually the main reason why I even decided to do this video, because for me, I think it's a good move. And there are lots of Chinese, like when you come to Ghana, for instance, in Kumasi, who are into gold mining and all that, and some of them default, they do some bad stuffs and all that, destroying our waters, and they arrest them. You understand? So I feel it's not like the Chinese are here and they are doing stuff and they are taking over Africa and all that. I think the authorities are also doing well. Maybe some other African countries are not really taking up these challenges, or the authorities or the institutions, but I feel they can do better. If in your country they are not doing this, but this happened in Ghana, and I think I'm really happy the authorities are doing the right thing. You understand? Yeah. So for me, Charlie, so hey, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel, and whatever you think about this particular action that has been taken by the authorities, that's the Ghana Revenue Authority, I think comment below and like the video, and please share. Thank you so much.